My name is Jennifer Bourn. I am a designer and content strategist at Bourn Creative and jenniferbourn.com.
Great. And you've been very busy this week, this past week, haven't you? We're at WordCamp Sacramento, where you're one of the primary organizers, and you just had, what, content camp that you just did? How did that go?
It was everything I wanted it to be for a first-time event. You know, whenever you have an event that you've never done before, you have no track record of proof that it's a good idea, right? So I was a little nervous about putting on my own first event that was solely mine under my brand that I was 100% responsible for on my own, but we had just shy of 70 people in attendance. And it went great. The feedback's been awesome. I got all kinds of video testimonials and good stuff for the future, so I'm definitely going to do it again.
Yeah, I saw you announced it, and I was like, wow, that sounds like a really great idea. And then, you know, life was busy and everything, and then all the social proof, all the hashtags, content camp, I'm like, I totally had some FOMO, because people were just raving about how you guided them in thinking about content strategy for their businesses. What were some of the things that you were taking them through?
So the first day was all about positioning and messaging. So figuring out how you talk about what you do and how you position yourself in the market. The second day was all about content creation. So you got really clear on what your message was and what you wanted to say. Now it was brainstorming an entire year's worth of content and figuring out what's the call to action and the conversion that you want and what happens, you know, after somebody consumes your content, what do they do next? And mapping that out and figuring out a plan to market that content. And then day three was all about content marketing. So they wrote a Facebook ad, they repurposed videos for their stories or their news feeds, and then we wrapped it all up by tying everything together in one plan, like a reference guide that they could use moving forward.
Wow, that's great. And I saw a lot of rather large companies had people that they had sent to your event as well. So you really made an impact, not just with people who might be designers or agency folks, but some rather large brands were there, weren't they?
We had a really good mix. You know, I pulled probably 50% designers, developers, content people from my networking in the WordPress world and things like that. But the other 50%, we had a bed and breakfast, a horse barn, a janitorial, franchise service, restaurants, all kinds of different businesses, a realtor, an insurance agent, you know, people, bloggers. They're all people that know they need content to promote their business, but we're all busy running our businesses and we all know we need to do it. And we know we probably need to do it more than we're already doing it. Or we don't know really how to get started, but it's something that we have to figure out. And so this event helped them do that.
And you've really made a name for yourself as someone who can help people do this through your work with WordPress. What got you involved with the WordPress community?
What got me involved in the WordPress community? That's a good question. I think the biggest thing is, you know, when I started with WordPress, I was just looking for a way to help clients make changes with their website, because I'm like, I don't want to have to change a comma for you. And when I got started, I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't know how to use WordPress. I didn't know how to build a WordPress site. But I reached out for help and I asked questions on Twitter, and I had people jump in that were willing to help on client projects or teach me something or show me the way or share a code snippet. And when Brian started in with WordPress, it was the same thing. You know, Andrew Norcross was one of the first people that jumped in, and they're like, let's jump on Skype. Oh, I'll help you figure it out. I'll help you write that code. Because being a developer was Brian's second career. You know, and I always laugh and I joke with Dre Armada at Sucuri that he was one of the first freelancers I ever hired. I'm like, I need help. And he jumped in. And I think we have this thing that when other people helped you get to where you are, you kind of want to pay that forward and get involved and help somebody else the same way that they helped you. And getting involved with our local meetup and WordCamp and everything else has given us that opportunity to help other people the way that we were.
Yeah. And WordPress kind of gave Brian sort of a second career, a second lease on life, really, because of everything he went through before. Can you talk about that?
Yeah, Brian's previous career was as a fire captain with the City of West Sacramento Fire Department. But that job gave him cancer, and he had gallbladder cancer. And in California, it's automatically presumed that it's from the job. And he knew at the time he was already kind of contemplating a career change, but wasn't quite sure. And when that happened, he knew he needed to make a career change for his long-term health. And WordPress allowed him to reinvent himself. You know, I needed a developer too, so that my developer I was contracting with at the time was a little flaky. So I think that was a little push in the right direction of like, I need help. And he's like, I could probably figure that out. And so he dove in and taught himself with the help from the community. So he's totally self-taught, or he'll say community taught. But it did. It gave him an opportunity to reinvent himself in a completely different industry and leave a career that he needed to leave for his own health and to work at home with me.
He's not, you guys aren't working together still.
Not anymore.
He actually got a new career also. So
it was a stepping stone. He keeps on moving.
He does. So he's working at 10Up now? Is that where
he's at? In January, he started at 10Up. Yeah.
Wow. So
then I'm back on my own, which meant I could do content camp.
That's great.
Yeah.
That's really awesome because you're really touching so many people and the work that you're doing in the community. And the WordPress community for you guys is kind of a family affair too, isn't it?
It definitely is. We've pulled our daughter up through the ranks. My son doesn't really care at all, but Natalie's gone all in.
She sure is. Yeah. And she really wowed some people on stage yesterday, didn't she?
How's a proud mom.
Yeah.
We were happy in the back of the room. Brian and I were cheering her on. But this is the third time she's spoken at WordCamp. And she's participating in a panel at WordCamp US this year, which she's really, really excited about. But it's been fun. She's a volunteer. She's volunteered at WordCamp Sacramento the last 4 years. She's volunteered at WordCamp Orange County. So she gets involved and likes to help out and do things. And I think she might step up as an organizer next year.
That's incredible. What has that done for her in terms of like her confidence as a young lady?
I think getting kids involved in things like WordCamp shows them an idea of what's possible for the future, right? What they could be a part of or what they can do. And it exposes them to a community of adults and other teenagers and kids that are supportive and encouraging. Like the number of people that have thanked them for being volunteers and have interacted with the teenage volunteers that we have with as much respect as they would have for an adult, I think gives them, like they feel empowered, right? And it makes them feel really good and it helps build confidence. Speaking at events and having people compliment her and say, you know, you've done a really good job, and or I learned something for your talk. I think one is inspiring for adults, but for her too, going back to school, it's helped her with her public speaking, with giving presentations at school. I think interacting with business folks and things at WordCamp and talking with people about her blog or learning about their business or even talking with sponsors inspired her to get involved in the Future Business Leaders of America Club on her campus. So I think the impact of being around a community of people that are excited to see you succeed and are really supporting other people is a really great thing. I wish more teenagers, more students, more college students would come and get involved and see there's a lot of opportunity here and there's a lot of support here.
There really is. Mm-hmm. And they're the next generation of WordPress, really. So she'll kind of grow as a leader in the WordPress community. Mm-hmm. Just, you know, we become the elder statesmen.
I know.
It's really great. She has been an inspiration to me just watching how she's grown over the past year even.
Oh, that's great. It makes me feel so good.
She's an incredible kid.
Thank you.
She really is.
Thank you.
And of course, you guys do some really fun travels, which I follow because I don't get to travel in much of the fun way that you guys do. So tell me a little bit about your family adventures to the national parks.
We are on a quest to see all 61. There are now 61 national parks. So we're on a quest to see all 61 national parks in the United States. By the end of this year, we will have done 30. So we probably could do them faster if we pulled our kids out of school, but they gotta go to school.
Sure.
So we're stuck to the same schedule most people are. Spring break, summer, Thanksgiving break. So we hit as many as we can in those short time periods. So our next one is over Thanksgiving break, and we're doing Mesa Verde National Park in Colorado, looping down to Four Corners through Monument Valley and back up to Canyonlands and Arches. But the whole family is going to WordCamp US this year because Gateway Arch is a national park, so we can check one more off our list at WordCamp US.
Excellent. I didn't know that.
Yes.
Wow. That's great.
Yeah.
So you're doing a panel or
I'm
a workshop?
I'm doing a workshop on brand messaging. So a little bit of what I covered at Content Camp, I'll be covering in my workshop at WordCamp US. So I'm doing a workshop and Natalie's doing a panel with Emily Lemma's on the panel. I think the DeRosa kids are on the panel. It's a whole group of kids and teens that are blogging, kind of talking about where they see WordPress going.
That's excellent.
I'm excited about it.
It's really cool. Where do you see WordPress going? What's exciting about WordPress right now for you?
Well, I don't think it's going anywhere. I don't think it's going away.
No.
I only think more people are going to be are jumping in and using it. I think Gutenberg is transformational. The new block editor is really transformational in what it's allowing people to do. I think that the more that we can have things like WordCamps, the more that we can have meetups and expose people to what WordPress can do and what they can do with it and how it can help their business grow, but what the community brings to the table, I would love to see that grow. I would love to see that grow. We come across a lot of people that say, I had no idea there was a meetup. I had no idea that there was an event like this happening. I had no idea there was such a vibrant community. I wish I'd found this sooner. So if we can find more ways to get people to events and to see what kind of community exists and just how supportive it is, then I think we can do some great things. Or greater things.
Yeah, excellent. Yeah, and I think I agree completely because there's so many ways of getting a website online, so many different tools that are out there, but nothing else has the community. Nothing else has that supportive network. And yesterday during opening remarks, I sat next to someone who was had two sites, and I don't know what sessions to go to. And it felt so good for me to be able to sit and say, okay, here's the sessions and listen to what her needs were individually and help her figure out what sessions were going to fit for her. Like Bash was not going to be.
Bash was not your best choice.
Not going to work for her. Sorry, Dwayne. But helping her fit, her needs to what the lineup, and then also picking out my own sessions. Because even though I've worked with WordPress since, the early days, there was still stuff that I could learn. You're coming to WordCamp Sacramento, so.
Every year, I'm like, there are sessions that are talking about something that I don't even know anything about. So, every year, it doesn't matter, I think, how much experience you think you have. There's always something new that you can sit in on, learn, and see what somebody else is doing with WordPress, or how they're kind of pushing those boundaries, or what tool they're using to do something that might be different. But one of the things that I love too is that we do the beginner track, because I think it's easy to get kind of jaded, or you've been in it for so long that you kind of forget about the beginners and kind of the struggles that they have. And every year when we do the beginner track, we hear two things from the speakers. We hear how invigorating and inspiring it is, and how much it kind of like gets them excited about WordPress again, because all the beginners are so excited and they're like, wow, that made me feel so good to be able to be so helpful. And they're all so appreciative to have a beginner track and have somebody explain it. So the speakers that teach in the track are like, this made me feel so good, right? And it gets them excited again. And the beginners are so thankful to show up and have people walk them through the basics, right? Day one is just all about how to use WordPress. Let's walk you through the dashboard, walk you through the admin, walk you through the settings, walk you through how to use Gutenberg, how to create blocks, right? But then day two is like, I have a website, what do I do with it? Right, like, what do I do with it? And we talk about social media and email marketing and different things like that. And they're so excited, and people look forward to that all year long. One of my favorite stories is we had a couple that came to the meetup in May, and they were struggling with their site, and we said, okay, they're struggling with the new block editor. We said, put the classic editor on, calm down, chill out, right? Come to the meetup. We have help nights at the meetup. We can help you, but come to WordCamp. We're gonna walk through how to use Gutenberg. We're gonna walk through everything. And yesterday at the end of the day, I saw them and they said, we got set up with new hosting. We got help with our problems on our website. We saw how we got Gutenberg, how it works. We took the classic editor off and we published our first post using the new block editor. And they were like, this was amazing. And they were so excited. But we were able to do that for them here and they wouldn't have been able to get that anywhere else.
That's great. And mm-hmm. yeah, I love the beginners too. Because, I mean, you could talk about, you know, the history of WordPress and everything. Somebody said yesterday, it's like some of the events that you could go to where, you know, people have been around for a long time. It's like sitting with the old guard in the lunchroom. And then sometimes in the company, it's really good to go sit with the new employees.
It
and
is.
They're excited. Mm-hmm. And that infuses new energy into everything. So
it
yeah.
really does. Yeah. It really does.
So what's next for Jennifer? What's on your horizon?
That's a good question. A lot of sleep.
Content, this week,
content camp and WordCamp in the same week was a lot.
Yeah.
But after that, Profitable Project Plan reopens for enrollment in November. That's expanding from a 14-week course to a year-long course. I think with I have several courses and several different things, and looking forward, I thought, I need to simplify things. So all the things that I'm doing are being rolled into Profitable Project Plan. So I have one course to manage, one group of students and participants to make ridiculously happy, one area of focus for that. So I'll be simplifying to Profitable Project Plan and then Content Camp. So I'm really excited about that. So that'll open in November, and then obviously we'll do Content Camp again next year. And we're already kind of tweaking it and fleshing out some new ideas for next year. And then I do a retreat for women called Accelerate, and that's happening in October. We're going to be doing our 2020 planning.
Excellent.
Yeah.
So you're really focusing on an education and mm-hmm. sharing all of your wealth of wisdom with the community and yeah. the world, right?
Yeah. This year I turned 40. And I think that there's kind of this thing, like when I was in my 20s, I was like, how much money can I make? Right? I want to build an empire. And then when I got to my 30s, I was like, calm down. Like, that's a little crazy. But still, like, I want to build my business. Like, I need to get established. I need systems. I want stable income and all of that. But then as I started nearing my 40s, I'm like, I think the mindset shifted a little bit more to, okay, I've built a stable foundation. I have a business that's successful and consistent and reliable. And, you know, I've gotten to a point in my life where we can travel and go on road trips and do all these things. And it doesn't hurt my business. And now I'm looking at how can I pay that forward, similar to how I can do that through the meetup or through being involved with WordCamp. But how can I pay that forward and have an impact and help someone else who maybe wants to be able to travel more and or take a vacation or just not work on the weekends or be able to quit at 5. You know, people that I see that I'm like, you're way more talented than I am, but you're struggling simply because you don't have the right systems or you don't have the right stuff in place. And if I can help them just make a few tweaks so they can continue to be their brilliant selves, but just do it a little bit easier, then that's where I want to be.
That's great. Well, thanks for sitting down with me today and taking
time away
from this very successful camp.
Thank
it was great
you.
To just connect.
I know, this was fun.
Yeah, great.